Live from NBC4 Columbus, this is NBC4 Midday, here for you.
Today on Daytime, a new season brings all new fashion options, and you'll want to check out the latest jewelry styles to wear this fall. We also look at the ways bullying is extending beyond the playground and how parents can help their kids. That's today on Daytime. Thanks for joining me today, everybody. And I am going to sit down with Robin a little later on the show and find out everything there is to know about her. We'll get the scoop. Also on the show today, the change of seasons is the perfect excuse to add new items to your wardrobe. So why not start with new jewelry? Our friends from Pandora at Tuttle Mall are here with a look at what is new for fall. We then switch gears for a serious discussion on the problem of bullying. There are so many more venues for kids to be mean to other kids. So parents really need to be on the lookout for signs that their child is enduring this type of abuse. And later we help on discussing bullying with your kids has become almost as common as talks about stranger danger, the birds and the bees, and with good reason. Bullying has been taken to entirely new levels of malice with the advent of social media, and it doesn't appear to go away anytime soon. So that's why it's important for parents to have open discussions with their children. And here with advice on starting that conversation is Missy Moody. She's with Adam H. Youth and Family Clinicals Manager. Nice to have you here, Missy.
Thanks for having me, Gail.
Unfortunately, we are seeing bullying escalate, but I think finally, as a society, we are kind of understanding that it's out there. What is, as far as you know, if you're a parent, what are some signs to look for that you might start to suspect your child's a victim of bullying?
Some of the signs, Gail, if you're concerned that your child is a victim of bullying, would be cuts, bruises when they come home from school, torn clothing, not having lunch money, not having eaten lunch, and then also if they're just having a little bit more aggression with siblings or a lot of anxiety, especially around school, that's out of the norm for your child.
And how do you get your child to then open up that they're being bullied? Because that's one thing many kids are afraid of. They want to hide it.
Right. So some of the things that parents can do if their child are being bullied to get them to open up would be just having those regular check-ins with your child, see what's going on, making sure that you're listening to your child and hearing, listening for keys and clues that there may be bullying going on. If your child is if you do believe your child is a victim of bullying, then you can take that further and speak with the school personnel. But just listening to your child would be a great way of finding out if your child is being bullied.
And we are seeing bullying extend to social media. So I'm sure you as a clinical manager are seeing so many more instances. And is that because kids don't necessarily have to identify themselves sometimes? They can anonymously bully?
A lot of times cyber bullying is a lot easier because it is anonymous. You can go online and you can have that cloud of anonymity, so
but sometimes
it makes it easier.
It's harder for the victim because they can't get away from it.
Mm-hmm. So one of the things that we try to tell parents and children if they're being bullied is to, you know, ignore the bullying, walk away. But on cyberbullying, it's a little different because you can't always walk away, and it's a little harder to walk away. But some of the same tactics for dealing that would be helpful as well with cyberbullying, as far as trying to ignore it, alerting teachers, parents, trusted adults.
Are you finding that schools are taking action? Whereas before, I think there was some criticism of teachers, of school personnel, of saying, you know, kids have been bullied for years, and they'll work it out. But are you seeing more action now on the type of, on the side of school administrators?
One of the great things that we're doing at Franklin County Adam H. is partnering with the schools to put in place programs for anti-bullying. It raises awareness of bullying, so it helps the teachers and the staff, as well as the other children, recognize signs of bullying and to be able to address it sooner.
Is bullying many times get aggressive physical? Do you see that as well?
Yeah, it can be physical. It can also be through threats. It can also be through isolation, things like that, social isolation, things like that.
On the flip side, if you're a parent and you suspect that maybe your child might be a bully, and I'm not sure what those signs might be, but you just might see themselves, maybe some snarkiness when they come home talking about other people or just saying, not necessarily saying nice things about some kids at school. How do you address that as a parent?
As a parent, if you think your child is bullying, again, you can talk with school personnel to help link you with different services that are in the community. You can always contact Franklin County Adam H. We work with a lot of agencies to provide services to families if your child is bullying or being bullied. So those are a couple of services that are available in Franklin County.
Well, that's good that you've called attention to those, because we will have your information on our website. And I think it's important for parents to know there's help out there.
Yes.
If they reach for it and look for it, and there's ways for them to cope and help their kids cope too.
Definitely.
Mitzi, thank you. Nice to have you here.
Thanks for
the information.
Yes, thank you.